Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about Picture-in-Picture, a really cool new feature that you can use with attended and unattended robots in UiPath. I have a neat little application here that listens for files to be dropped into this downloads folder. I can start it over on UiPath here. I'll just say, hey, it's called Forms Processes. I want to start it. I click play. It begins. I have this little downloads folder here. And if I paste something into it, you'll notice that a whole registration form pops up. There we go. We've got my Chrome browser starting up. And now that application is going through my whole Excel file and doing all these registrations for me. It's a pretty cool, pretty neat little application. But right now it's just kind of monopolizing my entire screen as it runs. Let me get out of here. Come on, UiPath Assistant. I want you to stop. And here we go. The job is now stopped. Now, let's take a look at how we can actually isolate that a little bit by running this in Picture-in-Picture. I think this feature is really cool. So instead of monopolizing all of my browser space, I'm just going to delete that file, copy it again so I can paste it back in and trigger this in Picture-in-Picture mode. There we go, just setting things up a little bit here. But as you can see, this application here, I've got the option to start it in PIP, Picture in Picture. I can also click this button here that says, hey, this will always run in Picture in Picture. But either way, I want to restart this application, but put it in Picture in Picture. And you'll watch how differently it runs. It runs in what looks like an isolated window. And I say looks like because I'll show you some of the drawbacks in a second. But there we go. I'll say start in Picture in Picture. It'll say, well, it wasn't verified and tested in Picture in Picture. And I know I should have clicked those buttons, but whatever. I was in a hurry. But now you actually see it running. It kind of opens up its own window. In this own window, it simulates a login into the Windows environment. I guess I've got to paste that file into the downloads folder to kick off the automation. But when I do on the host machine, and it's all the host machine, it's not like a virtual environment or anything, it's just an isolated picture in picture. Notice how this picture in picture window is now taking all of the input and the whole thing is being processed, not on one of the browsers that's sitting right next to me, but right inside of this picture in picture window. And I think all of that is pretty cool. Now, there are some drawbacks to this. And one of the drawbacks to this is the fact that I can still go in here and type. So notice that if I type something in here, my user input, my keyboard, my mouse, that's not blocked. And so the great thing about Picture in Picture is it allows you to look at what's going on and see the process run, but it doesn't actually block the user input. If you want to do that, you got to use the block user input activity. And if you stick around for the next tutorial, I'll show you exactly how to do that. But there you go. That's how easy it is to run an application picture in picture. Just publish. I'm going to stop my application here. But just publish your application from UiPath Studio into Assistant. Go to Assistant, find the process that you've run, and then just say start in picture, and it will. And there you go. That's how you use Picture in Picture in UiPath. Now, if you're interested in more about UiPath, head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great tutorials on UiPath, Orchestrator, DevOps, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on the YouTube.